Hello. Welcome to another painting. This one gave me a bit of trouble, but we started out as usual, masking the big shapes with ordinary masking tape and wetting the background. Payne's blue-grey again. As you can see there, top of the paper, I've bruised the paper somewhat somewhere along the line, which is what's causing those dark patches at about 11 o'clock, now at 5 o'clock. Because my pomegranates are lit from two sides, they have essentially two shadows. So this is the slightly weaker, softer. It's always a problem with gradient background like this, getting soft shapes to blend in. So quite a lot of work on that. And then a much, much darker shadow just underneath each pomegranate, which, being perfectly honest, is only partially successful. Very difficult to have a soft edge. This is Winsor Yellow from Winsor & Newton, mixed with a small amount of Quinacridone Rose. That's a mixture of the orange and the Imperial purple. The reflected light is much cooler. And just gradually building up the intensity of the colour. At this stage using a medium brush. Being careful not to paint over the purple, or the more of a grey colour really, but it was done with the purple. Here I've switched to a smaller brush deliberately to help create the small variations in texture. The surface of a pomegranate is quite textured, although it's smooth, it looks the colour variations are quite broad. Mostly just using the quinacridone rose. Switch to a closer zoom on the camera, as you can see. Again, working as quickly as I can, just softening the edge with water. The darker brown colour is a mixture of the Imperial purple and the Winsor yellow with a slight touch of the quinacridone rose. Here I'm just washing with clear water to soften the transitions between the colours. I'm just trying to build up the shaded area without losing the feel of reflected light. More of the Imperial purple. And then a really rather bold mix of all three colours, mostly purple, with the Winsor yellow, and warmed up slightly with the quinacridone rose. it ends up that I was a little bit too bold with that mix. But again, using a very small brush to help create texture. So deliberately not using a smooth wash. I'm just continuing to build up the shadow. Sticking with the small brush. And those areas had been masked with masking fluid. So I just rubbed that off with my finger. And as you can see, I've not mentioned it, but the half pomegranate at the front has also the edge overlapping the back pomegranate has also been masked with masking fluid. Now we're just starting to lift some of the colour to help create the feel that the pomegranate is round, so that the very far edge should be a little bit lighter. So just picking up, I don't know, around about a millimetre or something like that. And again, just washing with water to soften the edges, and then more work on the shadows. And having removed the main mask on the front half, I've now masked small white of the areas which I want to be white highlights later on. So you can see the paint running off the mask. painted quinacridone magenta. Winsor yellow. And that's more quinacridone rose. Starting to paint the areas where the seeds are. And deciding that was not quite the right approach to start painting the dark areas straight away, but I needed to be working more on the mid-tones. So painting the mid-tones instead with the quinacridone magenta. I don't know if you can hear the cat. She's not in the picture, she's in the voiceover. So building up the mid-tones in the areas where the seeds are, and then increasing the feel of the shell, what do you call it? Quick mixture of paint, and then letting it run into clear water. And again with the mid-tones, for the seeds. And finally, the fun bit, getting to paint the really dark areas. This is the Imperial purple with some Winsor yellow. where all our training with negative painting comes in. Painting everything except the seeds. A bit more work on the mid-tones and a bit of lifting, really just trying to work out in a small area a way of painting this in these areas before I do the whole lot. Again, using negative painting to define the seeds. And then just running that even darker red around the edges of the seeds that I have there. Again, just to see if I'm on the right lines, I'm doing things in a way that is going to work out. It's not always obvious exactly how you should be doing things. A little bit of a wash with quite strong quinacridone rose. Again, just going around the edges of each of the seeds, individual seeds, to try and blend the edges into the dark background. And a little bit of lifting to bring the highlights back. Still the same three colours, essentially. Mostly the Imperial purple. Bit more lifting, obviously, with my little bristle brush. And ending up with that, but deciding I've completely overcooked the back pomegranate, so 1 o'clock in the morning I took all the dark shadows out and started again with that, and deciding that the magenta was that I'd used for the mid-tones was too magenta, so I'm now going over that area with Winsor red. And obviously having to go back and rework those shadow areas. A thin wash of Winsor red even here, and a bit here and there just to create some balance, and gradually building up more tone. At least with a good quality watercolour paper, you can at least have a go at salvaging the situation. And this time, the darkest darks are much more of a medium brown colour. Same approach as last time, using a small brush. Still maintaining the slightly purple reflected light on the right hand side. Just toning it down a wee bit there. And that's more or less just the Imperial purple. Strengthening the yellow there, which had become paler with all the lifting. And this time using the Winsor red. And another wash on the mid-tones. And again going in with the Imperial Purple, a touch of Winsor Yellow to create the dark areas around all of the seeds. Slightly easier the second time since I know where the seeds are. And the same approach as last time, just going around the edges with even darker red to help them blend into the dark background. It's a bit deceptive before the paint dries. Just given a slight red tone to the outside. Still don't know what you call it, it's not the peel, shell. And having worked this area of the seeds so much, I've compromised my beliefs, and that's a mixture of titanium white acrylic ink and a little of the quinacridone rose. Deciding I was never really going to get the highlights I wanted just by lifting. Using white is something I try and avoid, but occasionally you have to bite the bullet. And that's more or less pure white. And there's the finished one, which I'm a lot happier with, although the shadows are still not as good as they might be. Anyway, thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and give me a like. Thanks. Cheers.